Good day, everyone. My name is Abiola Olawoyi. I want to teach you how to plot using AutoCAD 2007. So the first thing to do is to click on my AutoCAD, which is right here at the left side of it. Double clicking on the AutoCAD, it will launch my AutoCAD. And this is my AutoCAD is initializing. So once it's true, you see the crosshair instead of the mouse. Yeah, my AutoCAD is ready now. So I'm sorry, I'll be starting afresh. I misplaced my document, so I couldn't continue where I stopped on my previous videos. So I'm starting afresh now. So I'll say, as a surveying student or as a surveyor, the first thing you need to do when you open an AutoCAD to plot or to do anything is you need to first set your units. So just go to format and come to units. When you get unit, this is the drawing units. There are many things you will see there. You will see the angle, the length, the insertion scale, the clockwise, the direction, and also. So in Nigeria, I'm from Nigeria, so in Nigeria, I will use the standard for Nigeria to do this. So the angle type we use in Nigeria is degree, minute, and second. So I'll pick this. The precision will be 0 degree, 00 minute, 00 seconds. I'll click on clockwise. Then decimal, that is the length, it will be 3 decimal places. So, and this one will be in meters. The direction will be north. So that's it. Then okay, that's it. I'm ready for anything now. But the first thing we need to do now, if we want to plot on AutoCAD, we have many methods. But one of the best methods is to use the first coordinate, that is the starting point coordinate. Then you can use the bearing and distance of other points. So for this work, I will start with the first coordinate. Now, the first thing you need to do now is pick your line. You can pick line or polyline, but for the sake of this job, I will pick polyline now. So just I don't click on the screen, just leave it like this. Then enter your first coordinates, the easterns first, then northings. So I will start by 6, 9, 8. 8.363, then comma, that's when you input the notice 849.237.210. Just press enter. It has taken the points, the coordinates entered. So what you need to do now is to continue with the bearing and distance. So we start by pressing at, I want to press the bearing distance now, at the distance. The distance now is 78.59 meters. Now in pressing your meters, just press shift and less than. This is less than, let the less than button be there, let the less than sign be there. Then the bearing now is 281 degree. The degree will be T, and the minute 81 minutes, that's this sign. So that's the apostrophe or the column sign. So and press enter. Don't worry, it's plotting it. So let's press the four. I'm using a four corner work here. So the next thing I'll press at again, my distance is 32.06 meters, and less than, then the bearing now 41.51 minutes. Okay, enter again. Then the next point at 57.99 meters, shift less than, instead of comma you use less than, then the bearing now 112.58 minutes. Enter again. Then the last point, you can just go with close, but you don't have to go with close. Just make sure you press all the bearing and distance of your job. So the last distance now is 17.17 meters. Then the bearing is 172 degree. Then 38 minutes. So enter now. So welcome back from our previous video. You can see that we've entered all the bearing and distances. So we want to check our plan now, our plotted area. So you need to escape now. Once you press this, then you need to zoom to let us see. You know, you can't see what you've plotted now. So press Z, enter, E, enter. That is zoom to extent. Zoom, Z for zoom, then key to extent. You can as well come here and just try to zoom window. This is the area. So the next thing to do now is to input the bearing and distances. Now for this work, we know this is a polyline. Now you can explore the polyline to get the bearing and distance of each line from this from AutoCAD by itself. And before you do that, if you don't know the area of your of this plot, you can know the area by clicking on it, since it's polyline, and check the property pane. And if you can't find the property, you can just come here. You see the property here, this property, just click it and it will show here. So you can see the geometric side, you can see area 1514. That is the area of your plot, 1514.240. So as it's going up, the next thing I need to do now is to input the bearing and distance. So I would like to go down. You see the sign, a sign. Just click on this, then click on your screen and drag it down something like this, then click again. It will bring you to where you need to input your bearing and distance. But for the sake of this work, I want to teach you guys on something, how to format your test style. Just come to format and come to test style. Here you will see the test style pop up. So the standard here is the normal standard. Now you can click on new to set your own preferred one. I will name it Poma. Poma, okay. Then my font name will be Times New Roman. So this is Times New Roman. It will be bold. And my height, I want my height to be 1.2. So I will just click apply and close. So if I should go to the test now and try to add test, it will be as I've done in the test time. So my first distance is 78.59. So, and I will put meters. It shouldn't be in capital, that should be in small letter, meters. Then I'll press enter again to bring it to the next line. Then my bearing, 281 degree. I would like insert the degree sign. Just come here and check the symbols, and you should see degrees. These degrees, just click on it and to put the degree. Or for the sake of shortcut, you can press shift and then press 5 twice, 5 5, you know, it's bringing, then press D to bring the degree. So that's just it. Then space, I will space it very well because this line is very long. I will space very well, and 31 minutes, this is it. So I'll just drag this to make it close, and I will align all like this, put it at center, then let it be in the middle. So this is it. Now I'm placing it here. I'll just click on it and put it here. Then to send this very well, you need to adjust it. This is 241 degree, right? I want to set, and this line to the line, this long line is also 241 degree. This is the line. So how am I going to do it? I'm going to come click on the test, then come to the rotation. Since it's 281, it's greater than 180. That means I will subtract 281 from 180, and the result will be what I will use. And from this is 281 minus 180, which will give us 101. So I will just input 101 in the rotation here, 101 degree and 31 minutes. Enter. You can see that it has adjusted it to the normal thing. So Just repeat the step for the other one. So I will not be talking now. I'll just continue putting the BIR distance now. So this is the area and distance inputted. So I've already inserted in my work now. So the next thing for me to do is to input is to put the pillars, that is the beacons there at this point and point now. So what am I going to do is I will let you know. Now we come to format point style. The point style should be here. Yes, point style. Now there are things that are very normal. They are normal, but they're not accepted, but they are normal. So I'll just tell you one or two things about it. So assess size and absolute units, click on this will be should be the best. Then this point size now should be in 1.5. Then press OK. Now come and click on point here. This is point. Click on point and don't forget to on your snap and on it, put it there. You can see you have your pillars already. Now, one thing again I want to tell you is that this pillar, if you print this planner, if you print it, it won't come out. This place, the point here will not, that is this square, it should not be as dark as this line, because it's a point, it's not a rectangle. So we are going to draw a rectangle on it, like something like this. Yes, so you are sure that you have a rectangle on it already, like this. So this is a rectangle. Now you can still put circle here to make it beautiful, something like this. So click on the rectangle and click on the circle and come to copy here at this right side. Click on copy, then pick out from this center, then start pasting this at each point at all other stations. One, two, then three. So that's just how to input the pillars. So we see in the next video. Thank you.